Okay, ready?
Ready.
Moving in? Basically, what we're talking about, okay, this is, we're talking about the inspection of the fire extinguisher itself. So this is a regular dry chemical extinguisher, and it's what we call an ABC extinguisher, and you always know that because it'll tell you on the label itself. So ABC is in regards to the classifications of fire that this particular extinguisher can be used on. So Class A are your ordinary combustibles, paper, wood, plastic. Class B are flammable liquids. Class C are energized electrical. So televisions, computers, and whatnot that
so
are plugged
in. So it won't destroy my computer when my
right.
kids light it
now,
on fire.
Yes, but this particular extinguisher has residue. It's like it's sodium bicarbonate, which is baking soda. So it is going to have a residue, okay? So it's not the best if you're talking about for electrical stuff, but if it's a fire, you got to put the fire out. So for inspection purposes, you're going to find a tag on the extinguisher itself.
Right.
And really what's important is you're looking at this thing to see if it's been inspected. So over on the margin, on the right margin, it'll have a year. And it'll have a punch hole through it. So this is 2008. So that means that, and the month is just above it. So January 2008, okay, is the inspection date on this. Now, it's kind of interesting because on the back of this tag, which is kind of new, the inspector has to sign it. And he signed it on July 5th of 08. So they were a little bit late.
A little late.
Okay, but, you know. Regardless, the tag is there, which means that it has been inspected.
And the inspections are good for a year?
They will re-inspect every year. The extinguishers should be refilled if there's a problem, meaning like if you're looking at this little dial here, okay, you'll notice there's a yellow needle in a green shaded area. That means that by looking at this, there's pressure in here and it's ready to go. It's fully charged. But there's a 10% failure rate on these extinguishers,
really?
Meaning that even though it says it's charged, 10% of the time it may not work.
Now, for our guards, we want them to look at the fire extinguishers and check it. So is there something that they should be looking for in particular when they're looking at these fire extinguishers?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things, there's a lot of things. They can look at the tag, is one. They can also look to make sure there's a hose attached.
Okay.
They can look at the dial, making sure that the needle appears to be in the green, even though that's not an absolute. And bigger than anything else is if you look at the pin in here in this extinguisher, there's a little plastic tie. And if that tie is intact, that means that this extinguisher has not been used and the seal has not been broken.
Oh, okay.
So the better the chance that this is going to work.
Great.
Okay. And that's really what they should look at. And they should get in the habit when they walk by every extinguisher, no matter where it is, that these are things that they're paying attention to.
Absolutely. Okay,
it's their job.
Yeah.
I mean, they're talking about, you know, the difference between saving lives and losing them when you know where the extinguisher is located versus not.
Absolutely. So we're going to demonstrate it?
So we're going to demonstrate how to use the extinguisher. And I'll talk about the components of the extinguisher, just so everybody understands how it works. And then it'll be pretty easy. So, this is the dry chemical extinguisher. Again, you can use it on Class A, B, and C fires. So, ordinary combustible, flammable liquid, and energized electrical. Again, you got the handle, so this is how you carry it. And the top part is the trigger, how you expel the contents so you can put out the fire. The most important aspect of this extinguisher, if in fact you had to use it, you got to make sure that you pull the pin before you think you can put the fire out. So the acronym to remember is PASS. P-A-S-S. You need to pull the pin. You need to grab the end of the hose and aim. You're going to aim at the base of the fire. You're going to squeeze down on the trigger itself, the top part, and then you're going to slowly sweep over the base of the fire. And now we're going to demonstrate how that works for you. Okay, so now we've got the fire going. Now, ideally, you want to have a backup person with you for your protection. So if I am what we call the primary person, meaning I'm going to be putting out the fire, I would like my backup person to be chest to chest with me and at a 45 degree angle. That individual's responsibility is to put me out if I catch on fire. So their eyes should be on me and my eyes will be on the fire. The next thing that's important is I have to look at the wind direction to see where those flames are going. If those flames are coming at me, then ideally I want to walk around so I'm upwind of the fire itself. For two reasons. One, I lessen the chance that I'll get burned, and two, the powder is not going to blow back into my face and obstruct my vision. So, on my ready, I will look at my backup person and I will say, ready?
Ready.
And they reply, ready. I say, moving in, and I'll move in, and I'll sidestep, and now I'm going to aim at the base of the fire, squeeze, and slowly sweep. Never turn your back on the fire, sidestep out, and make sure that everything is safe, and that's how you use one of these extinguishers and effectively put out a fire. Hi, I'm Captain Stacy Gerlich, and I'm with the Los Angeles Fire Department. And the demonstration that you saw today was on the dry chemical extinguisher, or the ABC extinguisher. And my suggestion to you is that you review this training tape and make sure that you're comfortable with the components of the extinguisher itself and also in how to utilize this extinguisher. And if you're not, ask questions to those that you need to ask, and again, have fun and be safe. Okay, ready?
Ready.
Moving in? Backing out. That's kind of why I didn't say no. You know now how quickly the wind shifts. See, it was all going that way. Little compressed air won't hurt it.